All kids out of the pool for adult swim. All kids out.
You think when the astronauts landed on the moon, they had to fight off giant dinosaurs?
Giant ones?
Yeah.
What makes you think there were ever dinosaurs on the moon?
Duh. How else would they have gotten to Earth?
Sanford? Dell? Joe?
Oh, God. What now?
The corridor meeting is about to begin.
Did Todd say so?
That's me. I'm Todd.
Doesn't ring a bell.
Your resident advisor. I helped you move in. You asked me if my hair was cotton candy?
Oh, yeah. Is it?
Again, no.
Well, why not?
Anyway, the meeting is starting in, 5 minutes ago. Oh, God, what kind of example am I setting?
Who was that guy?
I don't know. Ask that guy.
Welcome to our first corridor meeting. I'd like to go over some ground rules.
College! Woo!
Rules. I've posted them again because somebody burned down the copy that was on the bulletin board. I added a new one that says no list burning.
College!
If you need to find me, just check this board. If I'm at class, the happy face will be in the space marked at class. You're gonna need to know this. Okay. If I'm in my room, the happy face will be here.
Where are you now?
I'm in the corridor, but please hold your questions until...
Which box is that?
There's no box for that.
So for all we know, you're not even here right now.
No, I'm here. Oh boy, I'm way off script at this point. This is not the proper evacuation procedure. Hey, if I were you, I'd put down that beer.
If you were me, you'd be drunk. And why should I listen to a drunk?
I listened to a drunk for 15 years. Then his heart exploded. His cold, black heart. It's my third grade ballet recital all over again. And then the meeting ended with some fat kid stepping on my groin.
Is that why you talk like that?
Like what?
Never mind. Listen, man, the guys on your floor aren't gonna respect you if they think you're a geek. You gotta be cool.
You mean cooler?
Yes. Much, much cooler.
If you're busy, I could come back.
No, Whitey was just leaving. If you'll excuse me, I have to counsel a resident.
But there aren't any girls on your floor.
One's gonna be in about 5 minutes.
They say the clothes make the man, so I need to find a cool t-shirt. Olympic beer drinking team. Too competitive. Make 7? What does that mean? Up yours. Touché shirt. I walked right into that one. Here's the one for me. If this doesn't make me cool, then I don't know what will. Oh, using a hot plate to make soup in the dorm. Don't worry, guys, I'm cool. I won't call the fire marshal. I don't know what stings more. The rejection of my residence or the bisque in my eye? It's the bisque.
Are you really the ultimate party machine?
No, not really.
Then isn't that like false advertising or something?
Well, I did have a party once, but when I blew out the candles on my cowboy cake, my hair caught fire.
Sweet.
You should have another party like that. You know, where you set your hair on fire.
But my hair is my best feature.
Okay, fine. I just thought it would be cool, that's all.
Wait, you think it'll be cool? Then I will have a party. I gotta go address the invitations. I knew studying calligraphy wasn't a waste of time. I only wish my father had lived to see this day so I could rub his nose in it.
I wish I had money for one of these. My body is craving one. It's like in the wild when a bear craves a monkey, but there aren't any around because it's molting season.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about being hungry, Joe. Something you wouldn't know anything about, rich boy.
I'm paying my own way through school, and I got a scholarship.
My parents couldn't afford a fancy scholarship.
I'm having a party in my room. Here's your invitation.
I'm so sick of you people thinking college is one big party.
But I thought parties were cool. Oh, I can't win.
They are cool.
This is too much of an emotional roller coaster. My lung can't take it. Nothing says cool college party like finger sandwiches.
Party!
I don't know if that's safe. Boy, I was right on that one.
Look at these tiny sandwiches. I feel like a giant.
Oh my god! Heimlich maneuver! Heimlich maneuver! Rosie!
Well, I'll put it out with this bug spray.
Oh my god!
Outstanding party!
But my poster! Really? You think the party's outstanding?
Are you calling me a liar? I'll kill you, you Trisket.
Wow, I finally lived up to my shirt.
Yeah, Todd, you're the man.
Todd!
Hey, everybody, Todd. Check out my six-pack.
Beer?
My daddy calls it beetin' juice. Here, catch.
It's against the rules to bring alcohol into the dorm.
Oh, that don't sound like the ultimate party machine. Have one.
But I've never had a beer in my life.
He's not as cool as we thought.
This is not outstanding.
I mean, I never had a beer I didn't like.
Todd!
I guess one beer couldn't hurt.
Todd! 3 days without an accident. That's a new record for barter. My God! I can't believe a drunk just fell out of a window. The college is turning into Hyannisport. This student's RA is going to get the chair!
I'm the RA.
You see, this is what happens when you have to hire based on quotas. Damn albino pressure groups. Until you're clean and sober, you are hereby relieved of duty!
Aw, oh, crap. Little help? Anyone? Todd? Are you in there? Todd? Where the hell is he?
Why don't you just holler for him? Whee! Hey, Toddy, get on down! Hey, Toddy!
Sweet!
If he don't come a-running after that, he ain't around. Or the coyotes got him.
As much as I enjoy your backwater capering, I need some toilet paper.
It might be wet, but it's a darn sight better than a dried-out corn cob.
Next, we have a new member of the group. His name is Todd Wolf Schmidt-Mansternowitz. No wonder he drinks.
I thought we were supposed to remain anonymous.
Damn it! I always do that. Oh, okay, okay. The meetings are anonymous starting now. Todd, please stand and tell us about yourself.
My name is Todd, and I'm not an alcoholic.
Son, the first step to recovery is admitting that you have a problem. Natalie just told us all what a drunken slut she was.
And now I feel good about how bad I feel about myself.
But I've never had a drink in my life. Not even a Shirley Temple. But that's mainly because I don't care for her work. I find her tap technique clumsy.
You have nothing to be ashamed of.
Except your cowardice about facing your problem.
And your freakish appearance.
You won't get your job back if you don't admit you have a problem, Mr. Wolf Schmidt. Damn it, sorry.
All right, if it'll make you happy, I admit it. I'm an alcoholic, okay? I'm an alcoholic.
There, that wasn't so hard.
Now can I be an RA again?
No, Todd. You have to complete 12 steps of soul-searing hell before you can get that monkey off your back.
That's not a monkey. It's scoliosis.
Someone needs a hug.
Please be careful of the hub.
Ow! I just stepped on some broken glass. Where'd that come from?
The bottles you idiots were throwing against the wall.
What are you talking about? Those bottles didn't have broken glass in them.
Besides, someone usually vacuums that stuff up.
That someone is me. But I can't sign out the vacuum cleaner because that stupid RA hasn't been answering his door. He signed on to do a job. Doesn't he know the meaning of the word responsibility?
Don't be mad at him. I don't know the meaning of that word either.
I think it's some kind of fish.
Don't bother looking for the RA. He gone.
What?
I ain't seen anyone in his room for 3 weeks.
Maybe it's haunted. I smell a mystery to solve. I give up.
You mean this room's vacant? As in, available?
I don't know, but somebody told me it's haunted.
Okay, step 4. Make a complete personal inventory of how I've hurt others. I was rude to Milo during last week's fire drill. Oh, how could something so bad look so nice? I'll tell you how. Calligraphy. Oh, darn it. Now I have to start over.
Let's all congratulate Todd, who has successfully completed this program. And to celebrate... Damn it, I always do that. Okay, okay, no more drinking, starting now.
So, can I get my RA job back?
Right after next week's graduation ceremony, Mr. Wolf Schmidt-Mansternowitz.
No last names?
Damn it! I'm sorry, I need a drink. This isn't going very well. Meeting's over.
She has the voice of an angel.
Could you keep it down? I'm straddling yesterday's hangover and today's buzz.
Oh, I do believe I have a touch of the vapors. So, my name's Todd. Are you in rehab too?
Nah, I just put away the chairs at the end of the meeting for beer money. You're in my way.
Oh, sorry. Here, let me do that for you.
Suit yourself.
Hey, where'd you go?
She left already.
How will I ever know how to find her again?
She'll be here every week. But you won't. After you graduate, I don't want you hanging around being a bad influence on the others. Lousy drunk.
I called you all here because our corridor's falling apart. And that's why I think we need to elect a new RA.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm on board with that. Definitely. Uh-huh.
Joe!
Someone who can keep the floor clean, counsel residents, and be their friend.
Joe!
Will you shut the hell up? I think that describes me. Therefore, I'd like to nominate myself.
You'd make an outstanding RA.
Thank you, Saladin.
Don't patronize me, Trisket.
So, if there are no other nominations, I'll just...
I'll nominate Sanford.
Thank you.
Sanford!
Outstanding. I love that, Trisket.
Sanford!
It is a great day when one of us graduates and moves on from our group, particularly when that person is as annoying as Todd. Todd, what are you... Is that my hat?
You reek of liquor.
I drank several wine coolers. Several. Although I did mix it with some grape soda to take a little of the edge off.
What did I tell you, Natalie? Freak boy fell off the wagon. You owe me a 12-pack. Now let's close with our prayer. Dear God, why are we such losers? Amen. Okay, out you go.
Hey, Matt.
You remembered my name had a T in it. I'm gonna put those chairs away twice as fast now.
Come here. There's something I want to do first. Closer.
Relationships are about sharing.
Hey, Joe. You should check out my new room. It's huge. Want to see it?
No.
Oh, okay. So what can I do for you? Do you need some advice about your love life?
Oh, please. I don't need anything from you. Can I have the vacuum cleaner?
Well, you gotta sign it out.
Fine.
Okay. You got a pen? And paper? And a vacuum cleaner?
What happened to the vacuum?
What didn't happen to it?
Todd may have been an ineffectual boob, but at least he cleaned up. He fluffed people's towels. He changed the light bulbs. And he threw away the glue traps when they had mice on them.
There are glue traps here? I gotta check that out.
You have the most beautiful hair.
Don't let me get puke in it. I have a date tonight.
Ew.
That's disgusting. If I were RA, I would have had this place cleaned up and organized by now.
That's the difference between you and me.
I know.
Hey, don't blame me. I voted for you. Didn't you hear me? I was chanting your name.
Joe.
It looks like there's a leak out there.
Someone should report that to someone.
Hey, Cindy. I'm almost done doing your job. Can I drive you home tonight?
That'd be great. Pick me up outside Andy's pub at 2. If I'm not there, check the dumpster. Or the Indian casino.
You have such a wonderful sense of humor, which further proves to me that this is the right thing to do. Ow! Man, that was the plastic knee. The one that was supposed to last 100 years. Anywho, will you marry me?
I could never marry you. You're an alcoholic.
I'm not an alcoholic.
All right. You're really ugly.
That I can accept.
Sorry, Todd.
You remembered my name. This parting is bittersweet. My physical pain is surpassed only by my emotional pain. No, I was wrong about that, too. Ouch, 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 ouch.
Uh-oh, the fire's going out.
Hey, those are my medical books.
But if we don't keep the fire going, the dogs will come back.
This has gone on long enough. I'm taking over this floor. You're out. You hear me?
Yeah, you're out. Standing. But seriously, you did a really bad job, you stupid Trisket.
No problem. It was too much work for me anyway.
Stop arguing. It's done. Now we just need to find a new RA. And because there is clearly no more qualified candidate than myself...
Hey, you! Take your damn hands off of that mop!
It's Todd! Todd's back!
You can't come back now. I'm the RA. I finally got my single room.
Being an RA is my lady, and no one steals my lady without a fight.
Wait, that's the ladle you used to scoop crap out of the urinal.
That's right, Hotshot.
Fine. The room and the ladle are yours. Oh, shut up, all of you.
Aren't you gonna clean this place up?
Yeah, it smells like a cesspool.
No, it smells like home. I'll never leave you again.
Woo-wee! Hey, Piggy, Piggy, Piggy! Hey, get on down there, Piggy! Woo-wee!
Along with four other arcade classics, including Galaga, Pole Position, and more. Just plug it and play it. An entire arcade inside one joystick. Rated E for everyone. Batteries not included. TV games from Jack's Pacific. Products sold separately.
Look at the size of those M&Ms.
They're ogre-sized, just like him.
That's a lot of chocolate. Must be under a magic spell.
So what do we do?
Well, when it comes to breaking spells, usually somebody's got to kiss somebody.
That is not going to happen.
Ogre-sized M&Ms. Get them while they're big.
Ooh, look at that big yellow M&Ms over there.
That's the sun.
Yeah, I knew that.
Perverted filth.
One adult, please, for the X-rated movie.
I don't think I can walk anymore, Joe. I keep falling down.
When is the filth going to start?
Yes. I'd like a bucket of cop porn. Never mind. Just some good in panties. Wait! Wally! Oh, God! My next-door neighbor! Please don't tell! I came in here by mistake. I didn't know. Oh, my life is over! All because I wanted to see...
Midnight Cowboy, the Academy Award winner for Best Picture of 1970?
Yes! No! How could a porno movie win an Oscar?
Porno movie? Oh, back in the 60s, they gave the X to serious films meant for adults. Most of them wouldn't rate a PG-13 these days. Mercy, how times do change. You see, we're a revival theater, and I'm the projectionist here. We show the classics of world cinema. Care to come take a look?
That cowboy looks familiar. Wasn't he in Anaconda?
That's John Voight, back before he started to look like a raspberry. And you see that fellow? That's Dustin Hoffman.
Dustin Hoffman.
Oh, right, the old guy from Sphere. Sphere was excellent, I thought. Michael Crichton is a genius. Did you know he wrote Twister?
Just watch the picture, son.
That was terrific. And when Ratso died at the end, it was so sad. But a different kind of sad than when Bruce Willis died at the end of Armageddon.
Because this film was a personal vision, not a marketing machine like the pictures these days. Ratso Rizzo's not the kind of character that looks good on Taco Bell cups. Well, there's Gus.
Hey, Kevin. Come on, Slowpoke. I'm starving for dinner already.
Oh, Gus, you own a restaurant. You are standing in front of a restaurant. I'll see you later, Kevin.
That's right. I've been slaving over a hot stove all day.
Bring it in a bag. That's what I do. Bring your lunch in a bag.
Lunch in a bag. People will laugh at me.
So Wally's an expert in late cinema, eh? Go figure.
You didn't know? I can't believe you've been Gus and Wally's neighbors all this time, and you barely know anything about them.
Not true. I know they wake up at 8 o'clock every morning. Wally brews coffee while Gus reads the funnies to him.
Isn't it sweet? And then they shower together and sing college fight songs.
Then they either argue or have gay sex, and then it's off to work.
Tidligen har din fru bedragit dig, advokat Egerman.
Oh, brother.
SAE! SAE! We're the best fraternity!
Why, most regular!
Wally says this is the greatest science fiction movie ever made.
What is that stupid black thing? When are we gonna fight some aliens?
Whose baby is that? What's going on?
I understand. Wally, you've opened my eyes to a whole new world. And I bet Werner Herzog expert looks great on a college application, too.
Oh, Kevin, you're like the son God didn't want me to have.
So, what's coming this month? John Cassavetes, some Tarkovsky, The Man from Pluto, the lost classic from Walter L. Ford. Hey, this spaceman looks like Gus.
Kevin, a boy your age shouldn't spend all his time at the movies, but why don't you go outside and play some hopscotch or something? You can come back here again in 2 weeks or so. There's a good lad.
So, anything good this month? And by good, I mean something with the word vixen or blood-sucking in the title. Hey, Gus, this'll crack you up. This space guy is the spitting image of you.
Holy hog's brains. That is me. That's from when I was in this picture once that Wally made.
The classic director Walter L. Ford is Wally? Our Wally? Well, come on, what's the movie like?
I never seen it. You see, there was only one copy, but Wally said it fell off the side of a boat and got eaten by a shark.
But Gus, it's playing next week at the Hyperion. We can all go see it.
Hey, Wally, they found our movie. Ain't that great?
Why, yes, Gus, that's wonderful. Ow. I don't know. I guess they caught the shark or something.
Wow. I wonder how many other great films were eaten by sharks.
Wally, I can't believe you never told me you directed a movie. I sure hope we can see it together when it plays next week.
No, I won't. I can't. I'm having an operation that day, and I won't be able to talk about film for several months afterward.
And the movie is by Walter L. Ford?
Yeah. Look in our auteurs section.
Ah! Oh, I can't. can't believe how hard it is to get information about Wally's film, especially from Wally.
Kevin, there's only one guy in town who can help you with this. Brace yourself. I'm taking you to see the Beardo. You guys want to come?
Hi, Terry. Hey, Ted. What's going on?
You know, Andy, you still owe us a couple of overdue movies.
Yeah, Women's Prison Slumber Party 2 and Escape from Chinese Women's Prison.
What? You know, the best of the bunch is Hell Island for Stewardesses. It's got June Lockhart as the warden.
Oh, please! June Lockhart did not play the warden, you moron! She played a government agent who came to the island to investigate the warden's suspicious activities. I swear I employ idiots in my store.
Hi, Beardo. This is just my little brother. He's a movie nut like you.
Yes, but I'm only interested in the, classics. I came to ask about a classic non-perverted film, The Man from Pluto by Walter L. Ford.
The Man from Pluto. Of course! The original print has been lost for years. A classic if there ever was one.
Come on, hurry up. I don't want to miss a second of Wally's big premiere.
You've been working really hard on this, Kevin. You and Wally must be pretty good friends.
Well, we have been going to a lot of X-rated movies together.
We found the man from Pluto and the man from Mexico, but we can't find Wally anywhere.
Found him.
It's awfully crowded for such an obscure film. How do they all know?
Pluto, lonely Pluto, land of ice, a snowy world beyond the stars.
Pluto's not beyond the stars.
But what if this frozen world got blown to bits? Blown up by a nuclear bomb. Would we of Earth then dare to face the anger of the man from Pluto?
Sure is scary, fishing at night like this, eh, Bill?
You said it, Raymond.
Because I am here to destroy yous all!
Is this movie insane, or is it me?
Maybe somebody put drugs in our popcorn.
All them nuclear bombs have been fired, General, just like you asked.
Did you shoot them at Pluto to test our new devices?
You bet I did. Sure seemed like an awful waste, though, blowing up Pluto. A planet that never hurt nobody.
Well, I sure hope no one lived there.
You can say that again.
The man from Pluto is heading south. Calling all cars. Calling all cars.
Oh, no. What have I done?
This here is a map of space. And this here planet is Pluto.
Do you think that's where the man from Pluto is from?
Could be. And now I have no choice but to kill him. Him, who never meant us guys no harm at all. Your weapons is like toys!
Look it! His light is lighting up!
He must be mad or something!
I will blast you all! Oh, yeah. But first, I will fly to Washington to talk to your leaders.
How come they're laughing at me, Wally? You're supposed to be scared.
That's it, love. We're going. You just didn't get it, did you? Did you ever wonder why I didn't want to talk about the movie? No, you had to humiliate me in front of a crowd. Come on, Gus.
I ain't going in just yet. I need some time alone to think. Look, just so you know, when I come home, I'm going to be very drunk and very dirty. Excuse me, fellas.
Wally, please. I was trying to help you.
Just don't talk to me, Kevin. Don't ever talk to me again.
Oh, how could I have been so stupid?
Shh, you don't want to wake up Gus.
He came in here last night by mistake.
Wally will never speak to me again.
That's not true. He's a big boy. He'll get over it. Man, I can't believe how amazingly bad it was.
Yes, I felt amazement at the badness.
Okay, who's been testing their nuclear weapons on Pluto again?
At least now it is done with. Mm-hmm. Today I can return to obscurity with some nice, quiet Peckinpah films. Oh dear.
Jim, please, where did you put my fish?
Stop calling me Jim. Can't you see I'm an angry spaceman?
Oh. Hi. Wally, I respect you too much to lie to you.
Thank you, Andy. It really is quite a god-awful picture, isn't it?
No, it's just... Yes, it's the worst movie of all time. So what happened? I mean, why did you make a thing like that?
I've been asking myself that all day. See, back in 1958, my dreams were in Hollywood, California. I was a first-unit cinematographer working under Otto Preminger. It was a fine job, but I wanted to direct. Kirk, that was swell. I think we got it. Oh, kid, there you are. I just had lunch with Jack Warner, and he wants you to make a picture with two hot new stars, Charlton Heston and Paul McNewman. Heston, McNewman, those aren't exactly movie star names. Don't like the names? We'll change them. You got it. Point is, Jack will shoot anything you want. You got a script? My script was called They Come From the Stars, and it was my dream project, an allegory about Cold War politics.
People of Earth, I come in peace as an ambassador from the Galactic Federation.
He's lying! I say, blast him!
And cut! Reset for the big showdown! Everything was going swell, but there was one thing I hadn't counted on.
Mr. Langford, where you want me with this?
Oh, where wouldn't I want you with that? He wasn't as handsome as Charlton Heston, granted, but to me he was more glorious than all the Paul McNewmans of the world combined. Everything would have been fine if I could have kept my work life separate from Gus, but I was a young fool in love. We have a casting change. The visitor from space will be played by the star of tomorrow. Give a hand to Mr. Gus Dunch.
Hiya. Oh, come on. Whatever that guy did to get that part, I can do better. See ya.
Kid, what the hell are you doing? Why, the studio will have your head on a pike. That was the first time in history that an agent told the truth.
People of Earth, I greet you from the Galactic Federation. Gah!
Walter, I admire your picture, I do. But really, I simply can't tolerate bad acting. It's either me or that damn dirty ape.
I like the sound of that. With my other star gone, the financing collapsed. I had to shoot in cheaper digs across town. And I made more casting changes. Well, we'll make this work somehow. Action!
For eons, we have observed you! Wally, I can't say this stuff.
Yeah, it's too hard.
Well, we'll just have to change the story and rewrite the script.
I will blast you with this here ray. Wally, am I supposed to be mad or not?
He always looks mad. You can never tell the difference.
We'll put a light bulb on his chest. Then when it lights up, we'll know he's mad. Gus! He just shot you! Hey, your bulb is on! You're angry!
Oh, yeah? Lot of things. Very dangerous things.
Stay so, back. What do you think? Kid, I'll give it to you straight. You're through. We got some money by signing away the drive-in rights, and we left town that same night. We used the money to buy Gus a diner, and that's been our life ever since.
Oh.
But you know, I'm not sorry about a thing. I love Gus, and he loves me, and I would do it all again in a heartbeat. Well, I better get to work. After all, laughable, pathetic movies don't just project themselves.
Oh, snap! Check it, Holmes!
I hope you know what you're doing! Oh, shit!
Hey, Sourpuss. What the hell is this crap?
It's an action comedy. Look, they're running away from a fireball.
What happened to Hitchcock and Tati?
After what I did to Wally, I don't deserve to see good movies.
Kevin, a very good friend of yours is being mocked right now. So you can sit here moping, or you can go help him out.
Either way, stop hogging the TV.
Oh, look at that. The squad cars are going backwards. Lordy, what was I thinking?
Maybe you were thinking about how far you'd go for Gus. You're the one who taught me that all great movies have a personal vision. Wally, this whole movie is your Valentine to Gus. It couldn't be any more personal.
Oh, that still doesn't make it great.
I'm not so sure.
How many of yous must get blasted before yous will learn? Nuclear weapons is wrong-hearted.
Oh, God. I haven't laughed this hard in years. When I get home, I'm flushing all my Prozac down the sink.
The guy who found this movie deserves a medal.
Found it? How about the guy who made it?
Oh, brother. That was quite the surprising evening. Thank you, Kevin. I owe you one.
So, you're not mad at me anymore? Are we still friends?
Sure. We're as close as an elderly gay man and a straight teenage boy can be. Well, good night. I'm home, love. What's this? Come to the bedroom and see what I found. Love, Gus. What the... Will you look at that? Oh, Gus.
Bill Oakley, Josh Weinstein Production.
Attention!
Adult Swim, all kids out of the pool. It's animation for mature viewers. Sort of. We've got specials. Regular series.
I warned her.
And some stuff that's, Hello, Betty. Adult Swim, Sunday at 10 on Cartoon Network.
I never stopped thinking about you. And when I heard you were back, I started to hope.
I could sense that things would never be the same.
Rated PG-13. In theaters and IMAX Wednesday, June 15.
Here we are, boy. Bullworth Academy. Have fun, Jimmy.
Hopkins, you're quite the nastiest little boy I have ever encountered.
Okay, I'm frightened. And I've got a weak bladder.
Hey, Aggie.
You can clean my shoes.
This school is filled with wild beasts.
You want me to steal your stuff back from a bloodthirsty mob of angry greaseballs?
Get used to it, kid. You're a man.
No, no, no!
I always knew I was a born leader, Ernest.
I can do anything I like in this place. Anything at all.
This place is full of bullies and maniacs.
Nonsense! That's just school spirit.
Come here.
You're a degenerate! The thing I trusted you!
You're a pig! You've ruined my life!
Bullworth is a microcosm for the whole world.
I like you, Jimmy Hopkins, but I need you to do something.
Go away, Jimmy!
And boy, that nose of yours, keep it clean.
Welcome to Bullworth!
This product is not yet rated.
Have a taste of my hot plasma and die, alien scum!
Save me, Ghost!
Fear not! I shall rid the universe of this vile force and obtain your habitant bod as my prize. Scantily clad vixen, I promise you that I shall triumph in the end. Hey, beautiful. How about you and the dog switching places? Man, my ass hurts. Damn dog run.
Your mistake was that you didn't have a pup of your own. Get a cute foofy one and all the babes will flock to you.
Hey, Alex, you want to meet chicks? Maybe you should listen to Fruity and get a little puffball.
Hey, even I'm not that desperate.
Heads up, incoming Mormon.
I hear they got it made. You know, with the wives and all.
Hey there, folks. What's shaking?
Nothing.
Just hanging out? Well, you know, that's cool, man.
That's cool, man? Who is this guy?
Narc.
Nice clipboard.
Why, thank you. I'm Stefan, and I'm a PhD candidate at the university here.
Ooh.
I'm Dr. Hikester's TA.
Arr.
And I was just wondering if you guys want to take a test?
As a general rule, no.
Yeah, but this one's for science, for mankind's benefit.
Dork.
And it pays $100.
I'm down.
Me too. Sorry, we only need healthy males between the ages of 18 and 24.
Look no further.
What about you, bro?
I don't know. What kind of test is it?
It's for the psych department, but I'm afraid I can't divulge any details.
Why don't you just do it, Alex? It pays like 10 times what you make at that dead-end copy job.
Dead-end desktop publishing job, Chaka. I could use it then. There's this Screaming Jay record. Fine, all right.
That's cool, man. Let me just get your names here. It'll be fun.
Oh, what the hell is that stuff? I don't know, man. It's kind of freaky. It's like liquid snot.
I don't know. This guy, he was kind of weird, but he offered us $100 to take a test.
And so did this friendly stranger also offer you candy and a ride in his big, shiny car? Was there any mention of Nambla?
You know, Jen, there was something strange about him. The way he kept saying, "That's cool, man." Like it meant something.
It's probably the secret code for, "I've got three more suckers to sign up for my dangerous experiment." You know the one. They wire you up, say something about testing your brain waves, then zap your teeth crispy. Then they toss you into the sensory overload chamber, centrifuge your ass. And then it's time for some experimental surgery. Or maybe they'll just knock you out and steal your liver.
I'm safe.
They won't be wanting mine.
I know what they're after, and it makes sense that they're only looking for young studs. Yeah, man, they're after my man fluids. They're gonna synthesize them and make a pill to restore sex power to old guys. You know what I'm saying? And we'll all get the Nobel Prize for inventing Fructagra, the most potent nookie drug around. Ba-dow, you be like a 2x4.
2x4, huh? Are those your measurements?
Bitch.
And to think, all this time I've been throwing my man fluids around for free.
Oh, no thank you.
A troll pencil. Are you gonna start carrying a Hello Kitty backpack, too?
I'm not about to leave anything for the brain police. No fingerprints, no DNA. Now that's thinking.
That's stealing.
I'm just breaking it in for Jen. You know, the girl could be right. This entire setup is real suspicious. Told you.
These cameras are kind of creepy.
Definitely.
This could turn out to be some kind of mind control experiment. Yeah. Maybe it's a plot. And who's behind it? Probably some combination of FBI, the mob, Freemasons, and bald little pigmen.
Pigmen?
Oh, yeah. They're the front line. They break down your will. Dismember your personality. Oh, you think you can hold out. But the tiny bastards know where you live. They isolate you and discombobulate you. Then they really go to work.
Goat, man, if you're so freaked out, why not leave?
Man, do you have any idea how much porno $100 can buy?
Actually, yes.
Oh, you're growing the thought police a little big these days.
At least she ain't no pig woman.
Huh? You guys here for the test?
If there's no electrodes involved, yeah.
Electrodes? Ah, that explains the screaming. I'm joking. Just sit down. Dr. Hikester will be right with you.
Did you see that? She looked at me funny.
Aren't you used to that reaction by now?
Newsweek? I need the Sports Illustrated swimsuit issue if they expect me to do my business. Assy. Even better.
You really think they'll ask us to take off our pants?
I wish.
But I'm wearing two-day underwear.
What are you so worried about? I mean, besides the underwear thing and the possibility of permanent brain damage.
You will observe this beautiful specimen of the condition I've described. I've never seen one so perfect and complete. Note the characteristic slump, the clenched buttocks, the shrinking testes. These are the signs of an individual who is afraid of life itself. Happily, since this specimen is too nervous to speak to a female, its chances of breeding are slender to nil. Now, if you will, I shall splay the subject and reveal the absolute absence of any guts whatsoever.
Wait a minute. I used to take tests because I had to. I don't have to do this. I'm getting out of here.
Too late.
Make bowl with the man fluids, partners.
Ah, you're here at last. Come on in.
Let's see. Charles Wagon?
My friends call me Chuck.
Okay, Chuck. And you are?
Goat.
Fruity.
Now, boys, you'll have to use your real names.
Yeah, next step, one world government.
No questions? Okay. When you're done, just hand your booklet over to me, and you may leave quietly. Are we all set?
Yeah,
let's do it.
Then everyone pick up your pencils.
Psst, no DNA.
Yeah, that's cool, man.
That's cool, man.
Open your test booklets and begin now.
I still have both my kidneys, I think. This is starting to be a good day.
Man, I was all ready for some Kelly LeBrock weird science action, but I didn't get to fill any bottles with my this and that.
You know what it was? A trick to get us all on file, but I outsmarted them. I got everything wrong on purpose.
Excuse me. Test number 37B, white male.
Me?
Yes, you, Mr. Wagon. Can I see you for a moment?
Oh, I told you there was more to this thing.
They check in, but they don't check out.
If he goes disappearing, I get first dibs on his Sailor Moon videos.
By all means.
Can't we just go to the bank?
These places are much safer. Anonymous. No way those bastards gonna force me to leave a paper trail. That's why I don't have a credit card and I stay the hell away from Blockbuster.
Maybe our boy's onto something. Like how they wouldn't give us a check until we fessed up our real names.
What are your real names?
I ain't telling.
No way, Hancho.
You know, I got this book that teaches you how to become invisible.
I think you're taking this a little too seriously.
Now, where do you think those pictures go? Into the central computer, that's where. And look at the number at the bottom of this check. God's sakes, it's got 12 digits. They've got everything they need.
To do what?
To control you, man. Those bastards are quick.
That's more than I can say for you. Move it.
I'll need to see some ID.
Negatory. You enemy puppet of the state.
Maybe the bartender at O'Sullivan's will cash it for me. See ya. I'd make sure those bills aren't marked.
So, Alex, what happened when the test lady called you back?
She wanted more information. Information is power, Alex.
Oh, nothing. She just wanted to say some stuff.
About the test?
Sort of. About the test. About, messing up. I filled in some of the dots wrong.
Man, I haven't worried about messing up on a test since I was 8. I took this spelling test. I remember, I really studied for it too. But the teacher hit me with this word I never heard before. Ballast. I don't even know what it means to this day. Ballast. B-A-L-B-A-L-L-S. The teacher thought she'd give me another chance. Try again. Household. Household. Let me think. B-A-L-L-S. Household. The point is, if you don't try, you can't fail.
You are so full of ballast.
Bite me. B-I-T-M-E.
I thought it would be harder than that. I mean, the questions were pretty dopey. About prime numbers, Great Expectations, stuff like that. Anyway, it was supposed to test how much of our education we'd forgotten. I did pretty well on it.
You forgot everything?
No, Mecca. I mean, I got all the answers right. That's why the doctor wanted to know why I wasn't doing anything with my life.
Good question, Mr. National Merit Scholar.
Yeah, teachers are always like, but Chaka, your brother was so smart. What's wrong with you?
You did get into that school for engineering geeks of state where there are like 5 girls in the whole place and the winter lasts like 6 months.
I only went there because of the scholarship. Mom and Dad said, try it out for a while.
You made it through what, like 2 years? God, I would have eaten a bullet in like 2 months.
But man, when Professor Kivowitz asked me what I wanted to focus on,
I find my own research into the coal slurry fuels an endless delight. So, what do you plan to specialize in? Fluid dynamics? Sol gel processing? Which area of engineering greases your gears?
None of them.
What?
I mean, I don't really like engineering. It's kind of dull.
Dull? Well, then step aside. There's someone out there who deserves this scholarship more than you do. Someone with a sincere passion for polymers, a love of linear circuits, a feel for foam.
Then you moved back home, we got that crappy job.
Temporary crappy job.
Wasn't that like 4 years ago?
Of course, the MK Ultra gang was definitely wise to the MJ-12 deal. So remember, encryption is the future.
Yeah, whatever. So, how should I spend my wad? Video game? Fly sneakers? Nah, something to get the chicks.
Don't look back. Just come on.
Let go of my arm. You're acting mundo loco.
We're being followed. Don't turn around.
Oh, yeah. I see them. Bunch of government ninjas just waiting to kick your paranoid ass. You gotta get a grip.
A grip on a beer? Man, this thing's freaking me out.
You do that. I got some disposable income to be disposing of.
Answering one of those anything goes personals?
Nah, I'm thinking of applying for a job at Big Copy. The, big one over on Astor Place. They need an assistant manager.
Ooh, maybe they'll make you supervisor of stapling.
Can't you be encouraging for once?
I don't think this is such a good idea. New responsibilities might interfere with the development of your superpowers.
Very funny.
Oh, wait! I know! You can use your superpowers to bring the duplication business into the new millennium. Should I go with the Manila or the Wheatstone tablet?
They're both nice, but the Wheatstone says 100% glass.
Excuse me? My replicant cat's name is missing? How's anyone gonna know this is my pet if Rentarp isn't on it?
I just recombinated what you gave me, sir.
This is useless.
Now you must die.
Go for it, Alex. The future of 21st century copying depends on you.
I have a shot of bourbon.
Rocks?
Yeah, that's cool, man. Hey!
You again. You're the guard. What's your twisted story?
But...
when you say, that's cool, man, am I supposed to turn into a zombie? The mirror. Who's behind it? I'm on to you. I'm on to you all.
Jen, I have to do something now or I'll be a sniveling underling forever. I'm gonna get me that job at Big Copy.
Alex, I am so behind you. But here's the thing. If you're gonna conquer the world of collating, I think you gotta have one of these.
Should I go with the manila or the Wheatstone paper?
They're both nice, but the Wheatstone says 100% class.
Excuse me? My cat's name is missing? How's anyone gonna know this is my pet? The name Nevis isn't on it!
I just printed what you gave me, sir.
These are useless! Now give me a refund!
Okay, okay.
Look who's all dressed up. Got a hot date?
No, it's just a tie, you know.
Maybe everyone should wear one. Make the place look more efficient. Get some gals in ties and short skirts, and we got a real hello little schoolgirl look going on. Know where I'm coming from?
Yeah, but I wish I didn't.
Hey, Alex! Check out my fat shades, man. Only $100. I'm gonna pull a fine chickie with my new air of mystery.
Yeah, I love those, man. I have a pair just like him.
You do? Man, they're looking fugly all of a sudden. Where'd I put the damn receipt?
Anyway, how's Goat doing?
I don't know. Last time I saw him, he was running from the black helicopters. I mean, I thought he stopped tripping on hallucinogenic drugs in the 80s. I don't want to be around when he decides to drill a hole in his skull to let the demons out.
Damn cameras everywhere.
Hey, here's something for your digital imagers in Washington, where you're gonna need one hell of a big lens.
Oh my god!
The travel agents in New York will save these days.
Oh, damn.
And I'm very pleased to meet you. To meet you, sir.
Hey, Alex, you gone retro lounge or something?
Nah, I got a job interview.
Oh, I thought maybe you were jumping on a cool trend, like 5 years too late, which would be quicker than usual for you.
It's the assistant manager job at Big Copy.
Ooh, sounds exciting. Catch me when I faint,
You're the one who said I had a dead-end job,
You do, But Alex, you're supposed to act young and crazy and grow your oats or whatever before you go all responsible.
Shut up.
I see. I've got a date with your sister. Alright, how cute. And maybe that explained why I never set her up with me. Not that I would object, Missy.
God, your boss is such a tool.
All bosses are like that. But you wouldn't know. You've never had a boss. You've never had a job, so...
Yeah, and people think you're the smart one.
You know, if you smoked less and jogged more, this wouldn't happen to you.
If I didn't jog at all, this wouldn't have happened. Why don't you run along? Donnie Marie, the rest of you. You think you can change Goat? Make Goat fit the mold. Well, I won't roll over. I won't play your little dog. I'm gonna fight you and your tiny bowl seed. Oh, yeah. You gotta make the world nice for rollerblading and lacrosse, huh? Gotta kill off old Goat, cause Goat don't fit in with your big fake hair and your nasty ass fake teeth and your friggin' little nasty snappy lips, huh? Everyone's gotta join the club. No bad habits allowed in your cork ass world. But I'll never surrender, because if you have your way, the whole world will turn into one great big Toronto!
Alex, is it?
Yes.
Nice tie, buddy.
Thanks. Nice shoes.
Oh, yeah? Well, these are my ass-kicking shoes for a kick-ass company. You don't mind the word ass, do you?
Not at all. I've even been known to say it myself every now and then.
Well, as long as you don't plan to sit on it, we just might be in business. Come on up to my office.
Scott?
Huh? How do you know my real name? This is it, isn't it? The pigman cometh.
You haven't changed a bit.
What the hell are you talking about?
Don't you remember me? Bernice, from high school. I thought I recognized you at the lab, so I followed you around. When you got all paranoid, I knew it was you. You've been going on about the brain police since ninth grade.
You look different.
Yeah, well, I tried to fit in back then. Dweeb drag. I even wore nail polish, but I realized this is the real me. A great big tattooed freak.
All right. The pigmen didn't get you either.
Huh? Yeah, sure. I guess not.
I see you went to a fine college. And the hands-on experience is pretty impressive as well. What we're looking for at Big Compy is someone who's got the human touch, knows what it takes to keep this corporate family happy. And I've got a second sense about you. You'll get to know your employees, their dreams, what makes them tick. Listen to their problems like a kind father or best friend. It's the quickest way to find out who's got their hand in the till or who's gonna put it there. And if they know you're watching, they respect you. Of course, there are always a few troublemakers. The hidden cameras are there to help you catch the sly ones. And then there's our random year analysis policy. You're the type who understands it's a productivity issue, not a privacy issue. You want your privacy? Stay home, that's what I say. I also say, welcome aboard. When can you start?
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Someone is not exactly wearing the sweet smell of success. Well, I'm glad I only lent you the tie. You're sweating like a pig.
Yeah, well, I have to get back to repro, man, and I'm late.
Hey, cheer up. 20, 30 years from now, you know, when I finally get the guts to crawl out of here and go for an interview, you know, I'm sure I'll blow it too, so...
Oh, no, I got the job, but I turned it down. It's one thing to work for a jerk, but those guys wanted me to be the jerk that everyone works for. I mean, look, isn't knowing who you don't want to be sort of the same as finding out who you are, kinda?
I'll say yes, and that way we can both pretend we've got some kind of a life lesson thing going here. How's that?
Works for me.
Okay.
Oh, and thanks. If I'd have taken that job, I would have had to hang myself with it. Oh, and if you see Goat, tell him he was right about the cameras.
Will do.
Pigmen everywhere.
I have no idea what the hell you're talking about.
Which color says classically trained actress to you?
Well, they're both lovely colors.
Yo, check me out, Alex. I'm gonna get all the fine chicks now.
A new fruit twistable. Your mama isn't here to kiss your bruises. If you have a sour attitude, lemon, then go home now. But if you work with me, you could become the only fruit snack with three bendable tasty twists. Sorry, grape.
I'm okay, sir.
Now, fall out.
Only the best fruit flavors can get in a new Kellogg's fruit twistable.
It's the fruit snack with a twist.
So
So I had just left the office.
Right.
And there it was, my dream come true of a chair.
Dad, tell me it's a joke. I mean, tell me you haven't turned into the kind of therapist who shops around on trash day looking for stuff.
Yeah, it's fun, Ben. You know, you wouldn't believe some of the stuff people throw away.
You mean like crap?
Well, you have to see this thing. You have to see it on a curb, really, to appreciate it.
Yeah, I can see why.
Which, let me tell you the story.
I'm listening.
I'm putting the thing in the car, and about 100 yards away is one of my patients who sees me moving this thing.
Oh, really?
And
so how come they didn't help?
Well, first of all, it was humiliating, and I'm not sure...
Oh, you mean picking up the chair was?
Well, I just didn't want her to see me and that bent over like that.
Yeah.
It was not a flattering view.
That's never is.
No. And rummaging through the trash.
Yeah. I mean, I'd question if I saw my therapist out there doing that.
Right. That's, I guess...
At least you didn't see you doing, like, all the stuff you do that I see.
Like what?
Oh, you know what I'm talking about.
No, I don't.
I mean, going through the trash is... That's one of your better qualities.
No, what, I have no idea what you're talking about. What kind of...
Why do you wear one sock to bed? Why do you do that every night?
That's,
why is
that's
it
just
necessary?
An eccentricity of mine, you know?
Well, I think if I paid a therapist $150 an hour, I wouldn't want to see him rummaging through the trash.
Right. What about 130? Maybe I could cut her a break or something.
You know, you can't even get this out of the car, Dad. It's too big. You wedged it in the back. What I suggest is we leave it in the car.
Yeah.
That's what I suggest.
Well, that's you know...
It's like an extra seat.
You're not helping.
Well, you got to get it out of the car.
I know. That's why. Here's the $20 for you to take it to the dump.
Dad, you can't bribe $20.
So when I was a little kid, I had to take an IQ test. Did you ever take an IQ test? And, you know, they don't tell you how you do.
No, because they don't want to create a...
But I think I know how I did, and it wasn't good, because afterwards the guy, he goes, thank you very much. Here's a yo-yo. Here's a... Don't eat it.
Yeah.
I'm sick of all these dyslexia people. Oh, what's the matter? Baby mixes baby letters up? Oh, poor baby. Explain that to the man in the iron lung. Oh, baby get a headache when he reads? Oh, what does that say, men or nem? I don't know.
Fred, you're too late.
I missed my appointment.
Yes.
So it's not a wasted trip. Oh, God. Can I listen in at the wall? So maybe who's ever in there now, I could learn from their problems?
No, Fred, don't do that. Use the intercom. You can hear much better.
I hope I don't hear a couple session. I hate when they complain. Oh, there's no variety in our marriage. We only have sex 3 times a month. I wish I had sex 3 times a month. Oh, you know, they complain. Oh, the passion. You're there, and you know what I mean? You could talk about a movie you just saw.
I don't have a girlfriend. Sometimes I like to pretend I do. I just stand in my apartment screaming, that's not what I said. No, I didn't say that. Easy! Easy! You know what drink I hate?
I don't know, Dave.
Guess. Come on. See, come on.
I don't...
No. Eggnog. I hate eggnog. I don't even know how they thought that up. Okay, I want to get a little drunk, but I also want pancakes. Eggnog sucks, and so do you, Dr. Katz.
Hey!
You're like one big bowl of eggnog.
Is it hard for you to enjoy yourself without the liquor?
I don't need to drink to have a good time. I need to drink to stop the voice in my head. And the voice in my head has a stutter. And that is very annoying. Kill your what? Kill your write it down!
Hey, Dad?
Ben?
Well, I'm just driving around and I don't know what to do with this thing.
Yeah.
I was going to take it to the dump, but do you know where a dump is?
I don't even think they have them anymore.
They put all the stuff on barges, and I can't go find a barge now.
You know, the dump used to be all the way out on I-31.
Well, you know what? This is starting to become a big pain in my...
I don't know why I thought this would change our lives.
Well, you never know. You're
just trying to replace your mom, the void that she left.
Thank God we have a family again.
Hi. I don't know if you remember me. I'm Lou Schneider. I'm here to see Dr. Katz.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, who do I talk to about billing? Because I've had a little trouble with my insurance company. They've been a little bit sticky about paying for some of this stuff.
That would be me.
Okay, well, here's the thing. They're saying that they're not going to continue to pay for this if there's no specific diagnosis from the doctor. So could you make sure that there's something on my form? I think they'll take anything concrete, like a corn or a bunion or...
Borderline personality?
You felt bad for the chair. That's what it was, wasn't it?
I didn't feel bad for the chair. I just, it reminded me of a part of my life that I've left far, far behind.
Yeah, that was the Naga hide period, wasn't it?
Your mom and I, when we first moved in together and we were very poor...
We furnished an entire apartment with trash.
You were squatters, weren't you?
No, we weren't squatters, but we would sit on things we found in the trash. She was very inventive that way.
She took an ashtray and turned it into a convertible sofa.
I have a terrible attention span, you know? It's just too bad. I'm 33 years old, and I can't bring myself to go to things that last longer than an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Someone said, oh, let's go to an opera. I'm not going to an opera. A short one is 3.5 hours. The only way I'd be interested in something that's that long would be if that night the opera was about me. Lou, you should come to the opera with us. Tonight they're doing Der Schneidermaus. Doctor, I don't know if you can make a referral for me. I have a friend, a very, very good friend, who happens to be a Mennonite, mm-hmm. and he lives among the Amish in a simple way. But he's got some pretty complex psychological issues. Do you have anybody that you can refer in that community?
A colleague of mine has a practice in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And when we're done with the session, I can give you a referral.
Yeah, because this guy doesn't feel that it's such a gift to be simple.
Well, it's not for everybody.
Well, but he has this. He has some colored underwear that he sneaks under his clothes sometimes, and he's very conflicted about it. He feels awful.
Are you sure you were talking about him?
Hey, can I ask you a quick question?
Has
my bad
no.
dad been, like, mumbling to himself and...
Muttering. Twitching.
Yeah, twitching a little bit?
No.
Good. Because if he was, that'd be crazy.
Mm. I'm a little
worried about him because, he picked this chair out of the trash and, you know, that's just the beginning.
Mm.
It starts with taking something from the trash and then, you know...
Well, Ben, there's nothing wrong with recycling.
Have you ever taken something out of the trash, though, and used it?
Yeah, I have.
Like what?
My retainer.
I think my parents rushed me toward adulthood.
Why do you feel that way, Lou?
Because they gave me an adult name. My name is Lou. My younger brother's name is Sam.
Yeah.
Lou and Sam? Those aren't kids. Those aren't brothers. That's a retail outlet. It's like Lou and Sam, discount carpet. How are you? Come on in. Those are names you shouldn't be able to get from the name bureau till you're like 45 years old. You get down there with your kid name, they trade it in, they give you your adult name, and you're all set. I mean, there must have been some huge mix-up. There are probably 2 55-year-old Jewish guys standing outside the name bureau saying, "We're Bobby and Timmy. We can't get our names." My wife is a teacher.
Yeah.
That's really weird to live with a teacher because your habits change. Like, I used to be on the phone, kind of doodling on a piece of paper. I'd leave the house. I'd come back 2 hours later. That same piece of paper is now on the refrigerator with the words, "Good work," and a big smiley face on it.
So she's supportive.
I don't know. When you're a parent, you give up your freedom. I mean, you sleep according to someone else's schedule. You eat according to someone else's schedule. It's like being in jail, but you really love the warden.
Well, your mom helps out. She's around.
My mom has become a little bit more idiotic since we had the children.
Mm-hmm.
The cuter something is, the less you are able to hear my mother speak about it. Like if she sees a Cocker Spaniel puppy, she says, "Lou, that puppy was precious." I mean, one more cute kid, and she'll just be like this mute walking around our house gesturing. I'm worried about how physically expressive to be with my sons.
Now, why is that, Lou?
Men have trouble with their physical issues. It's true. Watch the way men express physical intimacy. We can't hug each other, Doctor. If we hug, it's weird. We don't just hug and hold. What we do is we hug with one arm, and with the other arm, we pat on the back. That's basically saying, yeah, I'm hugging you, but I'm hitting you. We put on a lot of sunscreen when we go to the beach now. For the kids, you know, because mm-hmm. we're always afraid of cancer.
Do you use the really strong sunblocks?
It's SPF 80. You squeeze the tube and it's just a sweater comes out. Do you have any other tests for me?
We can try a word association.
Oh, good. Let's try that.
Baffle.
Oh, my God.
Stamp.
Oh, Lord.
Mother.
Jeez, oh, Pete.
Pudding. I'm not sure you understand how it works.
I thought it was the first thing that comes into my head.
Well, it's not... Okay, I'll show you the way it should work.
Okay.
You say the words and I'll respond.
Water.
Fountain.
Car.
Wash.
Doctor.
Love.
Please.
Help.
Listen.
Close.
To me. Doctor, please.
So was it upholstered or wood?
It was upholstered. That's.
Oh, see, I draw the line. I never take anything that's upholstered off the street.
Why is that?
Well, because things can hide in there.
I looked for cash, if that's what you're talking about.
Cash wouldn't be such a bad thing.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
You know, when you think about it, other
Julie's
people
right.
sit in their chair. Maybe they don't have any clothes on. You just never know.
I think about that in hotel rooms.
Do you think about that?
I think, all of a sudden, I can't be the only guy that sits naked on the furniture. Yeah.
That's a good point.
Yeah. So this patient is coming back in a couple of days, and I haven't seen her since the incident. And I'm not really sure how to handle it.
You could call her up, tell her you've ended your practice and moved.
That's such a cowardly thing to do.
Yeah.
I like it.
I think you're maybe a little overly worried, John, would be fair to say, Stanley?
Yeah, because this is a dilemma for me.
Yes,
but... That sounds embarrassing
as hell.
You know,
you have a couple of dilemmas, you get yourself a crisis.
How many dilemmas in a crisis?
Three.
Wow.
Hey, Laura, can I ask you something?
Dr. Katz, he started crying all by himself this time. I didn't say anything.
What? Oh, fine. I mean, I know... I want to ask you something else.
What?
If you saw somebody you know and respected...
Mm-hmm.
...take from the trash a large chair and stuff it in the backseat of their car...
Dr. Katz,
yeah.
If you like the chair, then keep it.
Okay.
Katz.
Yeah.
I run into this guy I went to high school with. I haven't seen him in 10 years. And I ask him, you know, so what's been going on, man? What have you been doing? He goes, guess what? I finally got an amp for my bass. Which answers a lot of other questions, like, are you still smoking a lot of pot? Are you living in your mom's basement? Doing that house painting thing?
Yeah.
All right, Dr. Know-It-All. Let me tell you about this dream I had.
Sure.
It's this really skinny kid from high school.
Mm-hmm.
He's, like, leaning up against a building.
Right.
And all these big kids from high school are going over to him. And I think they're going to beat him up. But it turns out they just want diet tips. Can't you figure this out, healer?
Well,
thank you, Pawsey. Sir
Pawsalot. No, I see. I think...
Dr. No Energy, let me ask you this. If you could go to the bathroom and candy came out, what kind of candy would it be?
Fred, what are you doing here? You don't have an appointment today.
I would love to get in on Tuesdays. Why are they so hard? I never did a Tuesday.
Well, Fred, you have to pay your dues.
Can I just sit here and read the magazines?
Fred, your appointment's not till tomorrow, so why don't you just take them with you?
Take them? Take them out of here? That wouldn't make any sense. That's so out of context, reading a magazine that's supposed to be here and not here. That wouldn't make sense. That'd be like eating pizza on a roller coaster. It'd be like... shaving on an escalator. It makes no sense. It'd be like listening to music in your car.
Dr. Katz, why am I such a cranky baby?
Well,
you're a cranky baby, you know that?
Well...
Dr. Katz, you and I, we share, like, the bald man thing,
because
I'm going bald. You know you're going bald when your conversations with your barber keep getting shorter and shorter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I sit down, I'm like, how about those... Next? What? We're done. Well, here's a tip. I can't, boy. That would be stealing.
Excuse me, you're another patient here. Could I ask you something? Could I sit in with you on your session? I need an appointment, and maybe if you pause or if you cough, I could slip in a question really quick. And then I won't even wait for the answer. I'll wait later, but I won't even take the seat. I'll sit on the floor. You can have the couch. I'm not here. I'm here, but I'm not here.
Dr. Party Panties, let me tell you this. I went home for the holidays, right?
No.
And everybody, all the men in my family are bald and all the women are fat. It's like a Metallica concert going on in my own home.
Hmm.
You know, you can say, like, can I use your bathroom? You know, nobody really cares. But if you say, I have to use the plop plop machine, it always breaks the conversation.
Right. So you have nieces, you have nephews, siblings, and grandparents?
Yeah, I only have one grandpa. We call him Grandpa Alive. But he still beats me at checkers.
Mm-hmm.
But I kick his ass at full contact karate. Oh, it's almost a crime.
Does Dr. Katz give you sandwiches or anything? Do you get frequent flyer mileage? Okay, I didn't think so. I knew he didn't, but I wanted to make sure that you pay to just talk. That's okay as long as that's the deal for everyone. There's no T-shirts or anything? That would be great.
You know, being the head writer and editor for Gugu magazine,
mm-hmm.
a magazine by and for babies, with stories like, Grandpa, give me back my nose, or, it's a whale of a tale.
Yeah.
Am I losing you?
No.
Huh?
I'm with you.
Tell me. You know, Katz, what is wrong with me?
Well, you know, that's not such a simple...
Come on, you bloodsucker. How long are you going to suck off my teat before you cure me? Fix this!
Hey, Dad?
Yes, sir.
You got a minute here? I got some problems.
Hey, where are you now?
Actually, I'm right outside the dump.
Yeah?
They don't let me in. It's not open to the public anymore.
What are you talking about, Ben? It's the city dump.
I know, but you have to have a license to dump there in order to...
Well, that is an obscene law. I mean...
Apparently you can't throw out stuff anymore. You gotta keep it.
Yeah, well...
I asked them if I could leave it at the gate, and they'd take it in, but they won't.
Will they accept it as a gift?
Now I can't get rid of it at the dump. I'm thinking about just leaving it somewhere, you know?
Well, that is what the dump is for. Traditionally, it's a drop-off place for all the things.
Not anymore, Dad. They've changed the dump.
What, is it all digital now, Ben?
It's nice.
Yeah.
They got a great setup here.
Well, don't get attached to any of that stuff.
Ugh, I could come here every day.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I just, you know, I'm starting to get fond of the old thing. It's like a friend.
That's what I've been saying to you, is that
a
chair can speak volumes.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah.
We're going insane. Hey, Dad, did you have that session with the woman who saw you making an ass
of
yourself?
Yes, yeah, I did.
Yeah? Well, what happened? Did she...
Apparently that was helpful to her to see me...
as a human being.
That's right, to see me as a human being and also as a rodent groveling through the trash.
Yeah, I guess that's got to help any patient feel good about themselves.
She thought the whole thing was pretty funny.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, you know, it just goes to show you, Dad.
What?
Huh?
It just goes to show you what?
I don't know. It's just an expression.
Sorry.
Take it seriously.
Sorry. You know, I'm so literal these days.
Yeah. What?
I said I'm so literal these days.
What's that supposed to mean?
How about a truce? How about we agree to not to listen to each other?
You're right. Let's flip a coin.
You go first.
All right.
No, let's choose up for who flips the coin. Odds.
Right. 1, 2, 3. Shoot. Damn it.
Laura, I know this is kind of weird. Can you be nicer?
Sure.
I'm sorry, because it's a little off-putting. Sometimes
you?
I have been treating myself a little bit better.
Yeah.
Been out for Chinese food a number of times recently. I just love Chinese food. You know why? Because it's immediate gratification, doctor. They get you Chinese food so fast.
Yeah.
Boy, I mean, you order it, and bang, there it is. Even takeout. When I used to live in New York, you'd call, you'd give them the order, you'd hang up, and then bing-bong, the door would ring. It was like they had a helicopter and a wok, and they just lowered it to you. I always get the same thing, General Chen's chicken. Actually, that's not always true. I get either General Chen's chicken, General Cho's chicken, or General Chow's chicken. I think that's the highest military honor that can be bestowed upon a Chinese general. Actually, I have a chicken dish named after you. I'd love to go to China and attend the Joint Chiefs of Staff's meeting, just to hear the introductions. General Chow, meet General Chen. General Chen, I love your chicken! And yours too, my friend.
Oh, I missed my appointment?
Yep.
That's okay, because I'm an upbeat... positive guy. I'm not negative. I don't dwell on things. Hi, sweetie. People are attracted to me because I don't mope. I accentuate the positive. I'm like someone you like.
So you know what I've been doing, Dr. Katz?
What?
Besides planning your murder, because I'm going to murder you. I watched the Discovery Channel, and you know what I've discovered?
No.
I need a girlfriend, because it is boring. And the more Discovery Channel you watch, the less chance you ever have of meeting a woman. Because it fills your head full of odd facts that come out at any moment. Like the other day, I'm talking to this girl, right? And all of a sudden, it's like, hello, did you know Hitler was ticklish? The sea otter has 4 nipples. Did you know these things? Hi, I know everything odd. Ask me how many bones I have in my hand. Don't run away.
Yeah.
You know... It seems like every date I go on, it always starts out really nice, you know. Oh, what do you do? Mm-hmm, me too. Yes. Uh-huh. And then it always ends with a girl screaming, my eye! Dr. Katz, can I ask you, are you an East Coast or a West Coast gangster?
Well, actually, I haven't really committed to either
one. Yeah. Get to it! Katz!
East Coast?
You know, it would be one thing if you, like, talked this way and, like, you said something important. But it's like you're like, shoelaces. What?
You know, Dave, we need to set some ground rules in here.
Come on, Katz, let me in! Katz, let me in!
Yeah, we're gonna have to stop now, Dave. Our time is up.
Oh, what a jip!
Behemoth, majestic, awe-inspiring. And home to the richest people in the universe. Simply hi, I'm Dr. Conrad Milo, welcoming you to the world-famous Conrad Milo Rehab Center, where affluent addicts go for a quick fix on their careers. It's methadone wishes and withdrawal-induced dreams, for wherever you find the rich, you'll find the rich in a stupor. Want a peek at the grotesque luxury inside where dependence meets resplendence? Sorry! Only the most privileged get that privilege. For a wallet bearing $8,000 a day, most major platinum cards accepted. Is that the famous falsetto singing leather-clad pop star who's tested more drugs than the FDA? We can't say. Could that be the blonde-haired, green-eyed TV shade demon whose bedroom bedlam got a thrown off 3 series in a row? You didn't hear it from us. So remember, when you've got a secret shame you won't leak to the world, so you'll have a sympathetic and fault-free excuse for your recent outrageous behavior, think Milo.
So let me get this straight. You want a glorified cappuccino and croissant clip joint where the rich and blitz get to spend 2 weeks in a hot tub instead of 6 years in maximum as a pinup boy for a guy named Backdoor Billy?
Yes, and I'd like to hire you for a job.
And a fine clip joint it is. Have I told you how impressed I was by the way that former child star didn't rob a convenience store for over 3 weeks after he checked out of your place? So, care for some coffee?
Oh, I never touch caffeine.
Good. There's only one pot. What led you through the hopelessly tangled underbrush of private security organizations to our door, Stellar word of mouth? Our fine client roster? Those flyers we put up in that public urinal?
I needed detectives who were so low on the ladder, there was absolutely no way anyone rich or famous could have ever heard of them.
Hey, we may not have the recognition of detectives who go around solving cases, but we do just fine, thank you.
What Duckman is trying to say in his endearing yet somehow it manages to scare all our business away manner is that we'd love to hear about your case.
Exactly. Let's hear what you got.
I believe someone is trying to kill me.
Do you have any proof?
This note!
Dear Dr. Milo, I'm trying to kill you. Nothing more definite?
I found a gun.
Probably a toy.
And a knife.
Proves nothing.
And this bomb.
I get these every day. Next time you might want to tell me it's on a timer. You know, for rhythm.
I was thinking you could go undercover at my clinic and take over my therapy group.
Yes, well, warn us next time you're planning on thinking. I'll investigate the lap of luxury as a patient. We'll let Corny talk to the sickos. Fluffy, Uranus, get your fuzz butts in here! Ah! Time for my smoking patches.
You followed, Mr. Duckman?
I'm taking a vacation. Where's my bathing suit with the padded bulge?
It should be in here, right next to your foam rubber pectoral enhancer.
This lemonade tastes terrible.
We were worried you were eating too much sugar, so we substituted finely ground chalk.
Chalk?
Studies show most adults are chalk deficient, and it's organic.
Oh, you like organic. Well, there's nothing more organic than a real live body. Grilled to perfection.
Mr. Duckman, perhaps when this is finished, an extra 2 weeks at the clinic might do you some good.
Me? Ha! Places like that are for the weak, spineless, people who are so blinded by their selfish needs they don't have a clue what they're doing from 1 minute to the next.
Duckman, you know those are mothballs, right?
Just so happens that my doctor says I need more camphor. Almost there, my clubfoot comrade. Time to mingle with the millionaires, gallivant with the glitterati, hobnob with the hoi polloi.
And with any luck, of course, keep a man from being killed.
Right, right. There's always the side benefits.
Who is that?
God, I wonder who that is.
Touch me!
Cyrus Red Herring, MacGuffin Security. Are you rich?
No.
Famous?
No.
Ever been sexually involved with a political candidate?
No. But I did get approached by an Arkansas state trooper a few years back. Well, I guess you found all the... Ow! That's where I put my espresso machine.
Ah!
What the? Look at this hellhole. Rats. Vermin. Body parts spread all over the room. Dr. Milo.
9.5.
Hard to believe these are the dismembered remains of Dr. Milo, the bloody tatters of his lifeless corpse splattered on the walls like so much worthless refuse.
You think that's bad? Look at the room they gave me! No air, no cable, no continental breakfast with those cute little jars of grape jelly. At least Milo's suffering is over!
Sacrifice is often a part of undercover work, Duckman.
Yeah. What's the story with your shoes? They're soaked.
Oh, tee. One of the office girls did a cannonball in my jacuzzi.
Jacuzzi!
Never mind that. We have to start our investigation.
What investigation? The cops checked it out, decided it was natural causes.
He exploded.
Hey, the human body's an ever-unfolding mystery. So, I'm famished. How's about we blow this pop psychology stand and grab us a couple of dozen greasy cheeseburgers?
Duckman, a detective lives by his code, and under that code, the case survives the client. By the way, also under that code, detectives get 20% off at Red Lobster, but don't even think about that now. I've done some preliminary work, including a modest-scale model recreation of the crime scene.
This is an exact replica of my cell.
Actually, it's not. My walls are asbestos-free. Maybe the group therapy session I'm taking over for Dr. Milo will help us put a few more pieces together. Are you coming?
When pigs can fly! I'm still not coming! I'm tired, I'm cold, and I've gotta get a room upgrade!
I'm sorry, Duckman, but it's crucial that we maintain our secret identities at whatever cost to our personal comfort.
Doctor, it's up to 102!
Somebody got a fever?
No, it's my sauna. Tell the other nurses I have a session first. If they get too warm, the towels are optional.
Saunas, nurses, jacuzzis! Where the hell do you get off to?
Admittedly, the almost godlike ramifications could be a bit seductive. As you'll see, they treat a wide variety of addictions here. Most often, however, they like to group patients by profession. For instance, this is the entertainment industry wing, television subsection. Child stars, writers over 25, development executives. Actually, someone else gets addicted for them, then they take credit for it. This special section is for celebrities actually addicted to checking into rehab clinics. With this class of clientele, naturally they run into scheduling problems. So they have drive-through rehab for those busy type A's who just don't have 2 weeks to give up. Well, we're here.
Hasselhoff is too a singer.
Remember, Duckman, this is a perfect opportunity to interview Dr. Milo's patients, but be surreptitious.
Cornfed, please. I'd rather try not to draw attention to myself if you don't mind. Oh! My two favorite comedians and that unlanced Boyle one of them was married to. Roulette, Roxanne, Boyle! Remember me, Duckman? Private eye, do a lot of undercover work.
Actually, you do look kind of familiar. Something just came up that reminds me of you.
Oh, yeah, my lunch.
That's telling him, Roxanne. That's really telling him.
Shut up, canker yanker, or I'll cut off your alimony.
That's telling me, Roxanne. That's really...
And look, is that Juan Jesus Maria Osnales? $6 million shortstop, role model, and substance abuser due to the intense pressure of making $6 million? And Senator Stephen Stark, one of the great drunken skirt-chasing patriots of our time.
Ahem. Yes, well, if you'll all be seated. Thank you, I'm Dr. Gelman.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
What are you talking about?
My name is Dr. Gelman, Dr. Nathan Gelman. Nobody knows me here, so I'm introducing myself.
Oh, yeah. Nice to meet you, Dr. Cornfed.
In light of Dr. Milo's tragic demise, I will be taking over his sessions. Why don't you each tell us who you are, what you're doing here?
Hold it! Time out! Priorities here. Can everyone check to see if you got any partially unsmoked butts stuck to your shoe?
I got my butt stuck to his lips. Does that count?
Yeah! I'm such a dink!
Hey, Shemp, you always act like such a suck-up, no-talent pile.
No, sometimes I sleep. I'll start. My name is John.
I'll start. My name is Roxanne. I'm here 'cause, like, I told the press I'm addicted to, like, booze or something, so I'd have an excuse for firing everyone off my show all the time.
Yeah. Hate to yawn and run, but happy hour is only 60 minutes long. It's obvious you hated Dr. Milo for exposing your little fraud, so you killed him. End of story.
Killed him? I loved him. He showed me how I was really addicted to attention and being sucked up to.
Sorry, Senator.
Hello, I'm Senator Stark. I like to drink, smoke, lie, steal, and fondle anyone within reach.
Join the club.
I did. It's called the Senate. Thought it'd help my image a bit to get reformed. And if that doesn't stick, I can always run for mayor of Washington, D.C.
Okay, watch my dust. 15 minutes to the knockers galore matinee. Old Filibuster Brown here killed Dr. Milo because he was about to expose this pervo's taste for sweet young legislative bodies.
Quite the contrary. He devised a unique way to help me overcome my biggest problem. See, whenever I touch this mechanical Senate page, I get a shock. Haiku! And the shock I get, Jim Cutter, is designed to keep me damn some from wanting to touch it.
Aversion therapy. By associating pain with a specific pleasure, you'll be conditioned not to do it again.
I doubt it. He's so damn cute.
Yo, Senator Juicy Fruit, save it for your next joint session. Oh! Okay, name's Roulette, and I'm here because my career was shakier than Roxanne's flabby butt after a jumping jack. Bada-bing, bada-bang, bada-boom.
You gotta run. 2-for-1 sale at the Rubber Goods store. Know the rest anyway. Blah, blah, blah. Killed Milo because you hate everyone.
What, they bust you in from a head injury ward? Milo made me confront my anger. Showed me it's wrong to hate those who are different than me. Except for homo, saggy-breasted women's libbers and those third-world types with the funny accents.
Thank you, Roulette, for expressing what millions of white trash neo-Nazis would love to say if they could hide behind the First Amendment under the guise of comedy.
Yeah, well, now that's wrapped up. Let's book. Got a Jones for a triple scoop of that tuna musk ice cream at... What the hell are you staring at? You mean you expect me to join in on this Fruit of the Loon club? Ah! Don't turn my crank. Unlike you losers, I don't have an addiction.
Duckman, you're living in a glass house with Mr. Denial. Think of us as the men in the moving vans.
It's clear our newest constituent is filled with fear and self-loathing. I think we should help him break down these barriers, starting with a warm and very wet group hug.
Duckman must die! Duckman must die! And I will be the one to end his misery. I'll roast his heart on a spit, and then I'll wash it down by sucking all his precious bodily fluids. Wait a second, I can't suck my own precious bodily fluids! I already tried that in high school. Ah! How much can one duck take? A whole week without caffeine, nicotine, women! Okay, so I once went 3 years without a woman. No, 6 if you don't count that open house day at the morgue.
How about you?
What's happening to me? I'm surrounded by hideous visions, horribly misshapen monsters!
Duckman, there you are. It wasn't easy, but we managed to sneak in here posing as a singing, mother-dominated Mormon family who've turned to vice because their better days are behind them.
And we only came here out of our genuine love and concern for you, Dad. Oh, look! There goes the entire cast of Beverly Hills Adjacent!
Oh, Yoo-hoo! Cheyenne! Dashio! Elizabeth and Joanne St. Croix!
And here comes Rockstar Stash! Peeper Magazine voted him most addicted man in America!
Hi, kids. Nice of you to come by and see your dad. Whoa. Sounds like all those years of being fried really took their toll.
All right! The anchorman from CNS just vomited!
Good news, Duckman. I just placed first in the Milo Clinic Celebrity Pro-Am Golf Tournament. Oh, and I'm closing in on the murder suspect.
If we solve this case, I can get out. Solve case, get out. Solve case, get out. More rock, let's talk. Solve case, get out. 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 Get it,
get out. Your attention, please. Will all suspects in the murder of Dr. Milo please report to the lecture hall for the singling out
Say compulsive aggressive!
Thank you all for coming. I'm pleased to announce that I've solved Dr. Milo's murder. His killer is in this very room with us now. Initially, I believed the doctor to be yet another victim of your common, everyday, spontaneous combustion. Until I noticed that his remains had an odor vaguely reminiscent of northwestern Wisconsin, i.e. dairy country. This was especially curious considering Milo's having overcome a childhood addiction to the lactose found in dairy products, an addiction which, in conjunction with a strange glandular condition, caused him to swell to 340 pounds by age 8. On the night of the murder, the doctor retired to his study for his nightly repast of beef klasky and potatoes chupo. Or so he thought. Milo's potatoes have been replaced with ultra-rich vanilla ice cream, causing his taut body to start reverting back to its childhood girth. Hoping to counteract the effect with healthier food, he bit into a banana. But sadly, said banana had been replaced by a banana-shaped wedge of Swiss Gouda. Desperate for relief, Milo tried to brush the taste from his mouth. But as any child of four could tell you, the ADA does not recommend brushing with Cheese Whiz. In a last-ditch attempt to pass the offending substances through his system, he rushed to his trusty water cooler. Regrettably, the water had been exchanged for Farmer Fred's Grade A pasteurized milk. That is, the new see-through crystal light version. And that, as they say, was that. Finally, Dr. Milo's remains were dumped into the toilet, the murderer thinking they'd be flushed away forever. Little did anyone know, however, that the facility's waste and sewage never actually leave the building.
Go on, Corny. Tell us who the murderer is. Tell us who did it.
You want to know who did it? Okay, I'll tell you. They all did it. All five of them played a part. Four of them responsible for switching a different food, one of them for the demeaning, degrading, and ultimately unsuccessful job of flushing the remains down the toilet. And all because they were being denied their addictions. A mass tantrum by a group of spoiled children who in their whole lives have never been told no.
This is outrageous! You can't prove we did anything wrong!
Yes, he can! Look! If I remember correctly, the NRA gangbang special. For the times when nothing but a group kill will do. And I'd recognize those trigger fingers anywhere.
Okay, we did it. But we has to ask Dr. Gelman. How did you know?
As fate would have it, my own addiction. Murder, She Wrote reruns on USA. Check local listings for showtimes. I knew if I came up with a preposterous solution that had a blatant disregard for the facts and defied all logic, then told it in flashback, it would be true.
Monkeys off our backs. We're going home. I, Duckman, have captured the murderer.
Zip it, Dorkman. While you were out playing slap and tickle with your new bondage buddy, Cornfed already solved the case. Milo's patience did it.
That's impossible. I almost killed myself capturing him. He has to be guilty. I want to be the captain.
Cyrus Herring, DEA. I've been undercover here for 3 months. These people were putting unadvertised food additives in their kelp. No charges. It's enough punishment just being him. Want me to drop these five off? I pass the jail.
I was thinking we could stop off for a hot dog. Speaking of hot dogs, you ever wonder why they call them Franks? I mean, why not Stans or Bobs?
Poor guy. No one told him they're not funny after they've cleaned up.
Like, now that we got caught, are we going to have to spend another 2 weeks in murder rehab?
We could buy our way out. We've got money. Well, she does. But I get to use some of it. Isn't that right, dear? Isn't it? Dear?
We didn't get autographs!
Yo, Agent Orange! You haven't heard the last of me! Somehow, someway, someday, I'll pin this on you!
Duckman, he didn't do it. He's just a seemingly suspicious character here to throw us off track. Think about it. Red herring, MacGuffin security... Never mind. Shall we rejoin the world?
Duckman, though Cornfed was, as always, the effective partner, I am impressed by all the running and fighting you did. Both sides of your face are still symmetrical, like you didn't even have a stroke.
You're right, Bernice. And I am feeling stronger. I can see past my hands. My hair doesn't hurt. I'm dried out. It worked. Well, this changes everything. From now on, it's pinto beans for breakfast every day.
Sex without a prosthesis. I've turned myself around. It's time to meet the new and improved Duckman. Yeah! Hey, you! Bob Noxious! Haven't you heard the stats on secondary smoke?
Ah, a whole new world.
And how better to start that world than with a pound of bacon and some curly fries? And coffee filters, used! I'll wear them around my face like a surgeon's mask! Hey, nurse! I got a thermometer that'll make you bedridden for a week! Where you going? It's time for my exam, see? I'm turning my head and coughing! Now it's your turn! Nurse! Nursey!
Autographs!
I could use a drink.
KFC Crispy Strips, 100% chicken breast, hand-floured and freshly prepared in the kitchen, so they're crispy on the outside, tender on the inside. And new at KFC, Hidden Valley Original Ranch. To step up from chicken strips to crispy strips, you gotta KFC What's Cooking.
One way or another,
Doritos, nacho cheesy or chips. That nacho cheese taste, that big crunch, nothing even comes close. Gotta get Doritos.
Freshman.
I know what's been troubling you. Listen to me.
Only through me can you achieve a power greater than any Jedi.
I can feel your anger. It makes you stronger.
Rated PG-13.
Oh, no, dude.
No kids in the pool. You guys are good. That's all kids out every Sunday and Thursday at 10 for adult swim.
Come on, let's go swimming.
It is at that time you will find a nice lineup of shows. Sea Lab 2021.
I like my body. I love my body.
Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
Good one, Jace.
Oh, yeah, good one, Jace.
Ah, now that's funny.
Home movies.
Name's McGurk. And soccer's the game.
The Brack Show.
Brack, I can't see. Am I on the road?
Not really.
Cowboy Bebop.
How you doing, kid?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Santa, what are you doing here?
Are you ready to rock?
And coming this January is Baby Blues. That's a new one for us.
How can you guys stand that noise?
But keep in mind, no kids under 17 allowed. Adult Swim, Sunday and Thursday at 10, only on Cartoon Network.
If you gotta get in the game, you gotta get with the family. Homer, Marge, Lisa, and Bart.
Don't you understand, son? Your whole life has been a video game.
This fall, roll with your homies.
Cool.
I start this riot in the name of decency.
Game over, man. Game over.
The Simpsons Game, coming this fall to every platform. ever made.
Whatever!
How do you describe a playmaker?
How do you describe a playmaker?
Guy who's clutch, who makes the big time plays
in big games, baby.
He pulls guys,
knocks guys, rips guys out of their shoes.
Bang, bang,
boom!
The playmaker makes the catch
over the middle.
He better not come across that middle.
Edge of your seat to your feet. He gets the stadium to go off.
Yeah, yeah. And the guy that I'm talking about.
He's an offensive guy.
He's a defensive guy.
Hey, Ray, talk to me on Monday.
What you say, Michael?
Offense, baby.
Playmaker?
He's a tank.
Sports car.
A semi.
He rips it away when it matters.
Never, ever coughs it up.
He makes the big pass.
He bats it away.
He makes the big run.
Big catch.
The big hit.
He makes the big kick.
What?
Kickers will speak when spoken to.
Introducing Playmaker Control, only in Madden NFL 2004, the official game of Playmakers. Rated E for everyone. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Taco Bell's new Ranchero Chicken Soft Tacos, bursting with so much great taste, you'll be floored by flavor. Make way for the big taste of the Ranchero Chicken Soft Taco. We pack it with our new marinated grilled all-white meat chicken. Then take things up a notch with freshly prepared fiesta salsa and a splash of zesty avocado ranch sauce. Whoa! For a burst of fresh flavor, think outside the bun.
Sorry, I thought you started the rain. The Lord finds you worthy. Okay, now!
Swim, yay!
Oh, golly. Mom, Dad, we have new neighbors! Mom, Dad! They're here!
How do I look?
Like you always do. Good evening! It certainly is. I'm Art Posibule. This is my wife, Poppet, our little boy, Block. And this is Christina.
Welcome to Morrelton.
What a lovely home. May I see your detergents?
I thought you'd never ask.
I brought some wine. Let me put on some music.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Orel.
I'm Christina. Hi.
Hi. I made you a welcoming present.
I have this, and this, hey, and this! Oh, no! Non-threatening Negro Comedy Volume 6!
My Uncle Willie, the guy was weird. Let me tell you, he would do weird things. Weird.
Oh, no.
And here they are, A to Z.
Oh, they're lovely.
And alphabetizing is such a good idea. I don't know why. I always put mine in chronological order. Yes, this is new.
Oh, but you've got Never Filth and Murder Dirt switched.
What? Thank you, Poppet.
The meek, the poor in spirit, the merciful.
Those who are blessed?
Right!
Hittites, Canaanites, Hebrews, wives, children.
Those who are slaves?
Yeah.
Say, she's kind of cute, huh?
Yes, sir. And Christina's such a beautiful name.
Of course it is. That's because of what it means. It means tiny little female Christ.
Heavenly Father, thank you for new friendships. In this cold, cynical, free-thinking, lonely world you've made, it's so unexpected when new friendships are welcomed with open hearts. In your name we say thank you and repeat your prayer.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we
forgive our two trespassers.
Debtors? Trespassers? What are you, nuts? Get out!
Well, you think you know someone.
Get up, kids.
I can't believe you would expose my children to this without my consent. Your children? What about my kid? He's only 9.
12.
Please, just leave. Gladly.
You don't even understand what the Lord's Prayer means!
How dare you! Forgive your debtors!
Forgive your trespassers!
You owe me a bottle of wine!
Get off my property!
I feel sorry for them. Don't they want to go to heaven?
People like them never do.
Not now, Shapey.
Why do they have to leave, Dad?
Because they don't believe in God the right way. We simply can't mix with their kind. It's dangerous.
There's a wrong way to believe in God?
Sure. You know the 21st commandment.
But I like Christina.
Well, why not try being afraid of her instead?
Oh, gee. I don't understand.
Okay. Now do you understand?
I guess so. Inspirational point? What's that?
Oh God. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, people come here to pray.
I didn't think you'd come here.
I almost didn't, but I had to see you.
Oh, Orel.
Oh, tiny little female Christ.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our...
Come on, Orel, say it. Debts.
Well, I shouldn't.
But we like each other.
I know, but... You scare me. You're different.
My dad says you're the different one.
Me? Gosh.
And forgive us our...
debts. Debts!
Oh, Orel! Say it again!
Get it right. Right.
Don't look at me like that.
Still hater. Tolerator. Tolerator.
Yeah!
Dad?
Hey! Come on in, half pint.
I feel guilty about something, Pop.
Oral guilt is for Catholics, you know that.
Yeah, but sometimes it just creeps in.
Well, that's normal. But thanks to Mr. Martin Luther, we Protestants have the freedom to learn about the cleansing act we like to call burying it.
And the place to do that is church.
Yeah, but I think I'd feel better just talking about it with you.
Save it for the repressional.
Help me, Reverend, for I feel guilt.
All right, hurry it up.
I've been cheating on my wife with Nurse Bendy.
Bendy? Jeez. Oh, well, you know, just try to forget about it.
It's going to be tough.
Yeah, no kidding. But you gotta push it way down. Whistle a lot. Pretend you're happy.
But it is tearing my soul apart.
All right. Say, three, it's not happenings, and two, I'll deal with it later. You'll be fine.
Ah, thanks, Reverend.
Bendy.
Hi, Reverend Putty.
Oh, hello, Orel. What's up?
Well, I feel guilty.
Uh-huh.
You see, I've been using the debtor's version of the Lord's Prayer.
What?
You know, instead of trespassing.
Yeah, I know. Orel, this is not guilt you're feeling.
It isn't?
No! That's the fires of hell lapping at your soul!
Gosh, how do I repress that?
You don't. You stop it at once. Using that version of the prayer is like believing in a Jesus without blue eyes.
Catch, God. Nice throw. Good arm. Here comes again.
Christina, we can't see each other anymore.
But we like each other.
I know. I don't want to go to the wrong heaven.
Christina, quit trespassing.
Yes, Daddy. Sorry.
That's okay.
Those poor heathens.
God gave them eyes, but they cannot see.
Come on, Shapey.
Goodbye.